In the United Kingdom, atheists and Christians have been fighting it out on the streets in recent weeks.
Yeah, this battle for Britain isn't violent. It is a war of words, though. And the two sides are using some unique vehicles to deliver their messages.
Ron Heather spends his day driving Britain's famed bendy buses. He works in Southampton for a bus company called First Bus. One morning, Ron walked up to his bus and saw a new ad printed on the side. It read, "There is probably no God. Now stop worrying and enjoy your life."
When I saw that on the side of my bus, it was the second bus of my shift. I thought, oh no, they've come here. What do I do about it? I can't just get on and drive it.
Ron, a Christian, left the bus and confronted his managers.
"Have you got another bus? I can't drive that bus with that poster on the side." "What poster?" "I said the No God poster." "Oh," he said, "well, we haven't got another bus." So I said, "well, I can't drive that. I better go home then."
The atheist-sponsored ads ran on 800 buses all around Britain in January. The British humanist organization, with help from famed atheist Richard Dawkins, raised more than $200,000 for the project. British Christian organizations like the Methodist Church and Theos, a faith-based think tank, supported the ads. They said the provocative message promoted healthy conversation about the existence of God.
And it was encouraging people to think about God. If you say God probably doesn't exist, that immediately creates the question, well, what if God does exist? And the issue there is it started conversations.
The Christian Party of Britain added its voice by creating a bus ad of its own. It read, "There definitely is a God. So join the Christian Party and enjoy your life." Party director George Hargreaves said Christians have to make themselves heard in British society.
The humanists and the secularists have been center stage in British culture for maybe 40 years, and this ad was probably the pinnacle of their cynicism. So we really felt that we needed to answer that with the truth.
Humanist groups have run similar ads in Canada and Spain and are planning to run them in Italy, Germany, and Brazil. In Washington, D.C. last November, buses featured a picture of Santa with the words, "Why believe in God? Just be good for goodness sake." Back in the UK, Christians say it's part of an ongoing battle over faith in the public square.
There is a spiritual war going on in Britain. I don't know about the rest of Europe, but there's a spiritual war against Jesus Christ and against Christianity and against Christians going on here. And we simply have to take a stand.
As for Ron Heather, he says he wasn't thinking about those issues when he refused to drive the bus that day. He just did what he thought was right.
As a Christian, you can't just leave your Christianity at home. You've got to be a Christian 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And I think in any walk of life, if something that is a direct conflict with your faith, you should put God first.
Fascinating. El Salvador's Christian community is helping that country through a tense presidential election season. They are in heated debates over one leading candidate's past as a member of a rebel army. Recently, more than 12,000 Christians marched through the streets of the capital, San Salvador. They came for a unified worship and prayer meeting at the city's national stadium. Current President Antonio Saca addressed the crowd. Believers prayed for God's guidance for the March elections on the 15th.
Well, you are just as likely to see the First Lady of Peru handing out shovels on a farm as in the presidential palace sipping tea.
Pilar de Garcia is on a campaign to help her countrymen defeat poverty and malnutrition. As Stan Gita reports, she's discovered some powerful allies.
Thousands of Peruvians live forgotten high in the Andes Mountains. They're vulnerable to disease and malnutrition in areas that have no running water, sewage systems, or electricity.
Almost a million Peruvian families live in extreme poverty, where the infant mortality rate is almost 50%.
The plight of these mountain dwellers has touched the conscience of Peru's evangelicals, as well as the First Lady Pilar Nores de Garcia. Together, they're now making a difference through a project called Sembrando, or seed sowing. And the First Lady says the goals are ambitious.
The albendazole whole pills, which are for deeper sighting, are given by the church to improve the health of mothers, diminish chronic malnutrition, and preserve the environment.
The First Lady's program promotes better kitchens with vents for cooking fires, Less smoke in the house means less throat and lung disease. Projects include latrines, reducing dengue-spreading mosquitoes, providing deparasiting pills, family gardens for better nutrition, and improved irrigation systems for larger crops in the arid Andean soil.
The albendazole pills, which are for deparasiting, are given by the church directly to my program, but at the same time, there is a direct financial contribution by the faithful.
Mexican gospel singer Marcos Witt gave the First Lady's program more visibility during a recent concert in Lima. He donated all the proceeds to the First Lady's program.
It's really a privilege when we can touch needy people. That's the heart of Christ. So it's a privilege to be able to do it.
The joint venture points to a growing social conscience in Peru's churches.
I believe the evangelical church is always alert to any call. The work of the church in Peru can be seen everywhere. In the remotest areas, there is the presence of the evangelical church.
It's time to bring together the church part, the world of influence that God has given us, and with the influence God has given her, create a greater benefit for Peruvian society.
Both the church and the First Lady hope that by working together, they will bring an end to the poverty and disease that afflict Peru's forgotten people. Stan Jeter, CBN News.